وَإِذْ قَالَ إِبْرَاهِيمُ رَبِّ أَرِنِي كَيْفَ تُحْيِي الْمَوْتَى. And just recall the time when Ibrahim said to his Lord, O Lord, let me see, show me how you will revive the dead. How will you raise the dead again to life? قَالَ وَلَمْ تُؤْمِنْ. Allah asked, do you not believe? قَالَ بَلَىٰ. He said, why not? I believe. I have the faith. وَلَكِنْ لَيَطْمَئِنَّ قَلْبِي. But I want that I should have the conviction, deepest conviction. My heart should be absolutely at rest. There shouldn't be an iota of doubt in me. So because I want that total and absolute conviction, that is why I have requested you to show it to me. قَالَ فَخُذْ أَرْبَعَةً مِنَ الطَّيْرِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, take four birds, فَصُرْهُنَّ إِلَيْكَ. Tame them to incline to you. Tame them so that when you call them, they respond to you, they come to you. ثُمَّ عَلَى عَلَى كُلِّ جَبَلٍ مِنْهُنَّ جُزْءًا. Now the details are not here. The details are which are omitted. Now kill them, slaughter them, and divide their body into parts, and then part of every bird, some parts of mix them and keep them on different hills. ثم اجعل على كل جبل منهن جزءا ثم ادعوهن. Then you call them the way which you had made them accustomed to respond. يأتينك سايا. You will see that they will be coming to you running. وَعْلَمْ أَنَّ اللَّهَ عَزِيزٌ حَكِيمٌ. And you should know and keep it in mind, and you should be convinced that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is almighty, all-powerful, and he has the all-total wisdom also. Now come two sections, and they are regarding infaq fi sabilillah. How balanced, you know. Full two sections were there regarding the fighting for the cause of Allah. Although it was related to the past history of Bani Israel. Scattered ayat we have found at many places about qital. Scattered ayat have been mentioned and have appeared at many places about infaq. But two sections, full two sections about qital, we have already read. Now two sections, full two sections about infaq. مَثَلُ الَّذِينَ يُنْفِقُونَ أَمْوَالَهُمْ فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ. The likeness of those who expend their wealth and money in the way of Allah. Now this should be very clear, what does it mean in the way of Allah? Infaq fi sabilillah has a definite connotation. There is the word sadaqah. Sadaqah is charity. Charity is basically for the poor, the needy, the miskeen, the beggar. Sign. This is sadaqah. Infaq fi sabilillah is actually jihad fi sabilillah bil mal. For the cause of Allah. What's the cause of Allah? Cause of Allah is that his deen should be supreme. As the Christians pray, thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heavens. On this earth also, the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala should be fulfilled. The law of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala should be enforced. This is the cause of Allah. And if you spend your money and your wealth for this purpose, this is infaq fi sabilillah. So actually, you keep it in mind. Sadaqah, infaq, itai mal, zakat, these are different terms. And every term has a definite connotation of its own. Although they can be interchanged, they can be used one in one another's place. Then qarz-e hasana, man alladhi yuqridu Allah qarz-e hasana. Who is that person who can dare give Allah loan, goodly loan? And these two terms, the loan to Allah, because when you are spending for the deen of Allah, it's the loan, personal loan to Allah. When you are spending your wealth for establishing the deen of Allah, infaq fi sabilillah. It's a part of jihad. Jihad fi sabilillah bil mal, that is infaq. Jihad fi sabilillah bil nafs, the final stage is qital. When you go risking your life, you go to the field of battle risking your life. مثل الذين ينفقون أموالهم في سبيل الله. The similitude or likeliness of those who spend and expend their money and wealth for the cause of Allah, in the way of Allah. كمثل حبة أنبتت سبع سنابل. This to the likeness of a grain which grows 7 years. في كل سنبلة مئة حبة. And in each and every year there are 100 grains. So one grain of wheat, now the plant, in that are 7 years, and in every year there are 100 grains. So one grain has grown into 700 grains. The same is the similitude, that if you spend for the cause of Allah, your reward will be 700 times at least. Why at least? Because Allah says, وَاللَّهُ يُضَاعِفُ لِمَنْ يَشَاءُ. Allah will double it for whomsoever He wishes. It can be 1400 times. But that is at the discretion of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. مَنْ يَشَاءُ وَاللَّهُ يُضَاعِفُ لِمَنْ يَشَاءُ. For whomsoever He pleases or wills, He will double it. وَاللَّهُ وَاسِعٌ عَلِيمٌ. And Allah is all-embracing, all-knowing. الَّذِينَ يُنْفِقُونَ أَمْوَالَهُمْ فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ ثُمَّ لَا يُتْبِعُونَ مَا أَنْفَقُوا مَنًّا وَلَا أَذًى. Those who spend their maal, they spend their wealth and money fi sabilillah, in the way of Allah, summa la yutbi'una ma anfaqu, then that they don't follow what they have expended with reproach and injury. And the other meaning may be by reminding of charity and generosity. Anyhow, you know, this infaq fi sabilillah, some person will be benefiting. And it will come in the end, inshallah, who they should be. Let me explain here, so that it becomes clear through all this discussion. When there is a struggle, a revolutionary movement to establish the deen of Allah, to make it supreme, there must be certain people who become whole-time workers. Otherwise, it won't work. Part-time workers cannot bring about a revolution. Part-time work can be a social service. Part-time work can be this type of thing, you know. Some education, some training, some social service. For revolutionary purpose, you must have people who are whole-time, whole-hearted, devoted fully. Otherwise, there can be no revolutionary struggle. Now, these people, who will support them? They also need. They must be fed. They must be looked after. Who will support them? That is why in the end of these two sections you will find who have the right of this infaq fi sabilillah. Who are the best to whom this infaq should be given? Those who have devoted all of their life, all of their time, all of their energies to the cause of Allah. Now they have no spare time, no spare energy to spend, to earn their own livelihood. They must be supported through this infaq fi sabilillah. And now if you have given something to such a person, and now you are mentioning it to him, this is injury. This is actually aza. You have given something to them, you have helped someone of them, among them, and then you are mentioning it, and you are, you know, impressing them more and more by your generosity. So that is very pinching for them, very hurting for them. That is the thing that is discussed here. الَّذِينَ يُنْفِقُونَ أَمْوَالَهُمْ فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ ثُمَّ لَا يُتْبِعُونَ مَا أَنْفَقُوا مَنَّمْ وَلَا أَذَى. مَن, that is to mention your charity and generosity. وَلَا أَذَن, and nothing, no injury to their feelings of self-respect and self-honor. لَهُمْ أَجْرُهُمْ, for them is their reward in the رَبِّهِمْ, with their Lord. وَلَا خَوْفٌ عَلَيْهِمْ وَلَا هُمْ يَحْزَنُونَ, and there will be no fear on them and nor will they grieve.